Hello my friends, my name is Vijay Kumar and we are studying refrigeration and air conditioning. In the last video, I have explained about the simple aircraft refrigeration cycle. In that video, that cycle was the without evaporator. And after that, we have seen the analysis of all the processes. Now, in this video, we will see the simple aircraft refrigeration cycle with evaporator. We will see it with evaporator. So, my friends, we will start from first. I have already explained. The atmospheric air will go from point number 1 to 2 dash. This is the diffuser. So, 1 to 2 dash, this is the actual process in diffuser. This is called ramming process. I will not write here now. Now you just listen the process, how it is going on, how air is traveling in this system. Okay, listen very carefully my friends. 1 to 2 dash is a ramming process, actual ramming process. At one point, pressure is atmospheric pressure. That means P1, if I say it is P1. So from 1 to 2 dash, it is a actual ramming process. So it is a P ram, pressure of ramming pressure. A means actual. So I can write P2 dash. So this is the 1 to 2 dash is an actual ramming process, and 1 to 2 is an ideal ramming process. Now, 2 dash to 3 dash or 2 dash to 3, we will see. After coming air from this side, it will go to the compressor. It will go to the compressor. Now, in compressor, isentropic expansion of air will take place, or adiabatic expansion will, adiabatic compression will take place. So, in compressor, adiabatic compression will take place, because due to irreversibility, process will shift to this side. Entropy will increase. I have already explained all these things. So 2 dash to 3 dash is a actual or ideal compression process. That is adiabatic expansion process. So air will go from 3 dash. I have taken here blood or tapping. I have taken blood or tapping from this point. Now air will go to the, this part is called heat exchanger. This part is called, this is an equipment which is called heat exchanger. Now, in heat exchanger, the air will reject heat. Air will reject heat. So, process 3 dash to 4, this is an actual constant pressure heat rejection process. This process will happen in heat exchanger. Okay, 3 dash to 4, this process is a constant pressure heat rejection. Okay, now, in this part, I have already told this is with evaporator. So here I put evaporator. Up to this, the cycle was same. Up to process 1 to 4. These processes are same as simple aircraft refrigeration cycle without evaporator. But here now we have put evaporator. In this evaporator, we will cool this air again. So, we will reduce the temperature of air more. We will reduce the temperature. At lower temperature, we will get the air. So, in this case, what will happen? The air will go 4 to 5. This is the process 4 to 5. If I say this, okay, now 4 to 5 I have taken. In evaporator, air will cool and this air will give heat. It will reject heat. QR in evaporator, if I say QR in evaporator, okay, you will get confused. It will be heat exchanger, it will get evaporator. Okay, QR in evaporator. So this amount of heat will reject from the evaporator. Now this air will go to the cooling turbine. This air will go to the cooling turbine, and in cooling turbine what will happen? Adiabatic expansion of air will takes place. So process, what will be the process? The process will go like this. If it is a isentropic process, but this is not an actual process, due to irreversibility in the turbine, air will go like this. So in this case, this process will not be there. If I say this process will not be there. Now, from 5 to 6 dash, I'll write here, this is the 6 dash. And if I draw, this is the pressure line. And this is the ideal process. So I can write in a dotted line. So the actual process will be 5 to 6 dash. Now from 6 dash to 7, air will go to the cabin. In cabin, air will take heat from the cabin. In cabin, I already explained, there are so much of heat is generated by the people, equipment and sunlight. All these heats will be rejected by the air. So from 6 dash to 7, air will take heat from the cabin. 6 dash to 7 point, air will take the heat from the cabin. At this process of heat addition will take place at constant pressure. At constant pressure. So the process will go like this. If I say this one, and these are the constant pressure line, you know. So in this case, 6 dash to 7, this will not be 5, this will not be 5 dash, this will be 7, this point will be 7. Now my friends, you can easily see the temperature has been reduced. So for more cooling, if I want more cooling, this system will be used. Okay, so in this case, I'll take air at very low temperature, so much amount of heat can be rejected. Earlier this was the gap, now this much is the gap. So if this is the gap, the refrigeration effect in this case is more. In simple aircraft refrigeration cycle without evaporator, the refrigeration bias was this. I've already explained, if you draw this, this was the cycle. So this was the refrigeration effect. In this case, it is the refrigeration effect. So friends, in this case, I have taken all the processes of simple aircraft refrigeration effect with evaporator. And in evaporator, how we will cool this air? We will cool this air with the help of air, with the help of ammonia, water, alcohol. We will use the evaporative substance. Ammonia, water, alcohol, we can use for cooling. This is called evaporator. Okay. So friends, in this video, we have seen the schematic diagram of simple aircraft refrigeration cycle with evaporator. So my friends, in this video, I'll not cover the analysis of all the processes. Because you are very smart, I have explained all the processes. If I say the ramming process and this compressor process, you can easily tell m dot cp into t3 minus t2 dash. the heat rejection, I'll say here the heat rejection, I'll explain what will be the heat rejection in this case. Heat rejection will be the heat rejection from process 3-4 plus heat rejection in 4-5. In these process, whatever heat is rejected, that will be added. So it will be QR plus QRE, QR evaporator. So the amount of heat rejection is QR is equal to in process 3-4. Sorry, it is a 3-. It is a 3-4 and 4-5. This much amount of heat, and you can easily calculate MCP into T3-T4 plus MCP into T4-T5. You can easily solve these formulae with the help of the steady flow energy equation. So my friends, we have seen the simple aircraft refrigeration cycle in this video with evaporator. To get the lower temperature, we will use this cycle. So in the next video, we will see the bootstrap refrigeration cycle. And for this video, thanks for watching and have a good day.